Welcome everybody back to Boost Emotion, guys, and today I want to make this updated video. I made a video a couple years ago about don't go with full catless downpipes. In this video, I want to give you some of the new information that I learned in the last couple years and share with you guys. So anyway, guys, hit that intro.
Welcome everybody back to Boost Emotion, guys. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. Thank you.
So welcome back everybody. So yes, as the title states, and from what I said a little earlier, should you guys run full catless downpipes on your Q50, Q60, VR30? And the answer is very subjective. And here's why I'm gonna sit there and tell you guys this. Number one, when you guys go full catless, you're removing a lot of the catalyst material out of your exhaust. Pretty much this catalyst material breaks up the exhaust so that the exhaust doesn't have as much CO2 emissions. Pretty much you're saving the earth, all right? We understand that, okay? Cool. Now, when you remove a lot of this catalyst material, now all that bad exhaust is going into the earth and you're killing the earth slowly. You want the earth crying? Come on, what are you guys doing? But anyways, the reason why I sit there and I've stated in an older video, and I'm gonna still say it right now, you shouldn't run full catalyst. This is why I'm gonna sit there and tell you. Number one, here's the reason. Most of you guys go full catalyst and you guys don't get a tune. It is required if you go full catalyst, you get a tune, please. And here's why I sit there and tell you guys this. Number one, the car is on stock tune. You remove the catalytic material. Your oxygen sensor spaces usually make the corrections depending on what the amount of oxygen is in your exhaust. Because you remove the catalyst material, a lot of those burnt off exhaust, which it would give off a certain amount of oxygen, you remove that. There's no more metal that would heat up and burn off all that excess gas. So now the car is gonna be thrown into a completely different type of tune, where the car is gonna release, maybe dumping a little bit too much fuel, and now more and more of those bad exhaust gases are going into the atmosphere. This is not good, all right? So you guys need to get a tune. That's the one thing. You need to get tuned so the car is running right and burning a lot more efficient. Now to go for two, here's why you guys are going to need to get a tune. Because the car also is running a specific amount of boost, right? You remove a lot of the back pressure off the turbines of the exhaust for the turbos. Why is this good? It's a good and bad way. In a proficient way, in a good way, the turbines are gonna be allowed to spool up a lot quicker. There's less amount of pressure on the turbines. Just to quickly sit there and try to explain it, you blow it like this, it's easy, right? But if you blow it like this, it's a lot harder. That's literally how hard it is for the turbos to sometimes push through the catalytic material, especially when they're spinning at 250,000 RPMs per minute. That's a lot, that's really fast. So you will gain quicker spool time out your turbos, which is good. But the downside about it is, now the car is used to having a certain amount of catalytic material. So now you may experience more boost spikes because now the turbos are spinning so freely, the electronic wastegate is gonna have a little bit of a harder time to control the amount of boost running from 10 PSI to 2 PSI because it's used to that back pressure of the turbines. So the car is literally confused and doesn't really know what to do. It'll still run right, do what it's supposed to do, but that electronic wastegate is gonna be working a bit more, and this is why you need to get the tune so that you can control the electronic wastegate so that you're not running into a lot of boost spikes. Boost spikes aren't good because at the end of the day, this can create leaks over time. I don't know how long this may take for you to get leaks. I'm talking about leaks within the cold side of the car, cold side coming from the turbo to the throttle bodies. No one has really seen it yet, at least from what I know, maybe because these turbos are still too small to give you too much amount of CFN of air, but still you're running between 10 to 20 PSI of boost. So at the end of the day, that can still run into more issues. Also, to add to it, I'm gonna shout out Edwin Young in this video. I made a video on Instagram with him like a year ago, and he said one of the positives on running full catalyst is you know how healthy the turbos are. When you run the turbos with no catalytic material, if you're pushing excessive boosts, if those turbo seals ever start going, you'll start seeing excessive white smoke if it's from antifreeze leak, or an excessive amount of blue tint smoke, which means it is an oil leak. Now, because you remove a lot of the catalyst material, you're still gonna see smoke through coming out your exhaust, because one of the combustion materials is water. You're literally gonna get a bunch of H2O or oxygen and hydrogen mixing together, and you're gonna get a bit of water. As it goes through the exhaust, that exhaust is cooling. And because it's cooling, it's turning from a vapor to a liquid. And this is why you're gonna see a lot more white smoke. So just make sure that white smoke doesn't have a sweet smell of antifreeze, because antifreeze smells sweet, or blue tint. But majority of guys who are gonna run full catalyst, you're gonna see smoke, because that's just what it is. Period. The exhaust is cooling through the cat-back system, and you're gonna have a bit more smoke than you usually have normal. Now, finally, to add to it, kind of want to bring this to a close. Some of you guys choose to have a boost controller, such as a JB4 boost controller or a Race Chip boost controller. I believe one or two other companies have come into this spectrum or making boost controllers. Understand now, the car was running a certain amount of PSI. You remove that catalyst material. So now, yeah, you have your car's running a bit more quicker because you removed a lot of the back pressure. You might have a check engine light. The car isn't running necessarily right when it comes to its carbon footprint. But now what you chose to do is add a bunch more boost pressure on top of it. So now you're not running 10 PSI, you're running 18 PSI of boost. Now, the car is now having to make aggressive changes to the amount of boost it runs, because you tricked the ECU to run more boost pressure. And now these turbines are spinning up to 250, maybe even 300,000 RPM for it to reach a certain amount of boost pressure. What I'm gonna tell you guys is this. Over time, as Edwin Young say, the turbines are gonna start showing you the wear and tear. So it is a good way of knowing that if your turbos are starting to go, because you're gonna start seeing a bit more blue tint or blue soot or black soot, or more white coming out, maybe because the seals may start to go. We don't know. It all depends on how healthy the car is and how you take care of your car. But because there's not much control with that, I don't necessarily like you guys doing that, because you could run into issues where you may blow your turbos, because you might have excessive boost spikes. The car might be, when you're changing gears, these boost spikes you're gonna notice whenever you change gears. So usually your car on stock tune is gonna run lower boost pressure at the higher RPM, because it doesn't wanna run into a lot of knock. When you change gears, it's gonna literally lower the amount of boost. The electronic wastegate starts to close closer to the higher RPM, and this is going to create a lot of boost spikes, because the turbines were spinning so fast. Even though the car opened that electronic wastegate, it just doesn't have. It's not big enough to let out all that excess amount of exhaust, so that the turbines will literally still keep spinning. And these are where these boost spikes come from. So to protect your car from running into these excessive amount of boost spikes, it is recommended, once again, still get a tune. So if you guys notice, if you're gonna go with full catalyst downpipes, get a tune. Do not do full catalyst downpipes on JB4. I know I have a bunch of people who still do that, that hit me up with my Boost in Motion. I still don't recommend doing that with you guys. Now, what I will say is this. Here's a catch. If you guys do want to run JB4 or any other boost controller with a full downpipe, here's my recommendation. Go full catted downpipe. This is a little better, because there's a slight amount of back pressure on the turbines. You still have that the added exhaust flow or wider pipes for the turbines. Which will still give you better flow, but at least the car is running right and making the proper corrections when it comes to fuel, and it's not just fully just completely open pipes. That's one of my recommendations if you choose to go that route. And also, depending on the state that you're in, running full catalyst downpipes may not be smiled upon. If you live in California, full catalyst downpipes are not really good. But if you live in New York, you can kind of get away with it as long as you can pass the emissions scanning. You know, so that's really up to you. Just guys, look up their emission codes where you live. I mean, the emission process where you live, and just work your way around that. But my recommendation, if you guys want to go full downpipe, unless you're trying to squeeze every little drop out of your car, if you want to go full effing catless, depending on where you live, go with a full cat, a full catted downpipe. But if you want to get all that power out, literally no back pressure at all, go with the full catless downpipe. And some of you guys who made this part, the difference between a full catted downpipe and a full catalyst is still a small amount. Yeah, it depends on how hard the tuner is pushing it, but the added stress, what's numbers is numbers. If you're a numbers guy, full catalyst. That's it. But if you want reliability, you know, the car's running right and burning right, you're not killing the earth, catted. But outside of that, guys, you have a good morning, good afternoon, good night. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. You have a good day.
Thank you, everybody, for watching. Do appreciate you guys, love you guys very much. You can also check out the two links I posted for some of my other videos. Also, on top of that, if you want to purchase some Boosted Motion merch, definitely check the link that I posted also. And finally, if you've been watching all my videos and you enjoy them, please hit the link to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.